Okay, now, for the seventh award, the TV Documentary Story of the Year, always one of the most heavily entered categories. To present this, I'm delighted to invite the Director General of Reporters Without Borders, Reporters Sans Frontières, Christophe Deloire. Welcome back, welcome back. First nomination for TV Documentary Story of the Year is Lali Houghton, Nairobis Rodriguez, Luis Del Valle, Posi Teng, Fiona Lawson-Baker, and Gino Moreno with Surviving Venezuela, Smuggling Dreams for Witness on Al Jazeera English. With no end in sight to the political and economic crisis in Venezuela under President Nicolas Maduro, people are growing more desperate by the day. For this film, Lali Houghton and Nairobis Rodriguez managed to secure special access to the smuggling trade in the coastal state of Sucre, and as a result managed to offer a rare glimpse into Venezuelans outside Caracas and how they are struggling to survive. The second nominee for TV Documentary Story of the Year, also from Al Jazeera English, are Fatma Naib, Petra Graf, Lynn Ferguson, and Farid Barsoum with The Cut, Exploring FGM. The Cut attempted to understand why FGM is considered an essential part of raising a girl and preparing her for marriage by millions globally. Journalist Fatma Naib, born in Sweden but whose family is from Eritrea, explored the traditions and controversies inherent in FGM on a journey which takes her from Somaliland and Kenya to Sweden. The film also explores men's role in the practice, as it's their views that will be crucial in changing the culture and perception of many communities. The third nomination in this category, Evan Williams, Eve Lucas, Patrick Wells, and Dan Edge with Myanmar's Killing Fields for Channel 4 Dispatches and PBS Frontline. With unique access to hundreds of verified, secretly shot videos, searing survivor testimony, and exclusive insights, this documentary gives a detailed account of the shocking violence unleashed by the military to drive 700,000 Rohingya from their homes, described by UN officials as a textbook case of ethnic cleansing with genocidal intent. This video proves that the Myanmar authorities started this campaign years earlier as part of a premeditated plan. The film also goes further in convincingly revealing the active complicity of Aung San Suu Kyi in failing to act and covering up the military's actions. In a very strong field this year, the judges commended The Cut for its intensely personal and beautifully shot investigation of FGM. But they were unanimous in their choice of a visually perfect and complete documentary that they said touched them on every level and which is backed up with immaculate research to provide an excellent example of the craft of documentary making. The winners of the Documentary Story of the Year, Evan Williams, Eve Lucas, Patrick Wells, and Dan Edge, Myanmar's Killing Fields for Channel 4 Dispatches and the PBS Frontline.
The Myanmar military says that it was conducting a clearance operation to rid Rakhine of terrorists. But video shot at the scene supports eyewitness claims that many civilians were killed. Nur al-Hakim went back to Monopara with a camera once the soldiers had left, at huge risk to his life. The metadata on the footage shows it was filmed the day after the killings. This is the first time he's been interviewed.
Evan Williams, Eve Lucas, Patrick Wells, Dan Edge, Channel 4 Dispatches. Thank you. Oh, yes, of course.
You're much better than I am.
No,
right?
No.
Eve. Just a quick thank you before I forget and never get commissioned again. Siobhan Sinodin at Channel 4 over there. Without her, this would not have happened. We went to her with the idea, and she immediately came on board with it. And her guidance for us on how we should do this was ringing in our ears the whole way. I'm not just saying that to get more stories, but it is very, very true. PBS Frontline, Rainey Aronson came on board as well. It was a real collaboration of public service broadcasting that made this happen. We spent 6 months trying to stand this up with the original material. We're deeply grateful to the judges, to all of you here, and to for the honour. It's a deep honour for all of us in being able to get this achievement. But importantly, I'd like to say that really, this award, we could not have made this film without the courage of the Rohingya citizens who, in many cases, risked their security and, in some cases, their lives to get that original material filmed on their phones and that we then used as the basis of this documentary. And without them, this wouldn't have happened. And a few people have said tonight, you know, rising authoritarianism, increasing nationalism. Many of us work only through the strength and courage of local journalists and citizens in many difficult places around the world. And I think this award, I'd like to think, gives them strength, but also to the Rohingya who are now languishing in those camps in Bangladesh who made this possible. So this is actually really for them. Thank you very much.